This particular Kyosho Mini-Z Toyota Celica has a few issues to notice. Well, first, it's the body. This body is pretty nice looking Toyota Celica WRC version. But because of the shape of the body and how it interferes with the chassis, when it's out of the box, it has the probability that the front wheel might rub the body, even with the original factory slick tires. So, to correct this problem, you might have to bend the body outwards a little bit to eliminate the rubbing at each of the four corners, here, here, here and here, which I did. Second solution is, if you are going to put your aftermarket rims, you can adjust your rim offset. I can't precisely remember which value it is. It's probably a 0.5 or 0. I believe it's 0.5 for the front one. So it doesn't really stick outwards too much. Then, when the wheel is sticking inwards a bit, it will help to reduce the probability of rubbing the body and while maintaining the normal functionalities. Well, second issue to notice is, well, because of the WRC styling lights. Oh, by the way, those lights are not functioning because there is no socket underneath, so you can't really put the lights as many other models of the Mini-Z. Where because of the headlights are WRC styling like this, sticking out quite a bit with the flip headlights. Of course, there is an option version of the flipped lights closed. This version, I still maintain the original open position flip lights, along with the additional headlights and the fog lights here. It's probably going to be very vulnerable during the accidental collisions. So to help to eliminate such issues, you might need to get the larger bumper for the Mini-Z series. I have the smaller bumper here. This Renault Megane has the smaller bumper here, and the smaller bumper will not work as great because it would be barely covering the fog lights sticking out as here at the bumper. So in this situation, it's better to purchase the longer bumper for the better productions. Third, the same as all Mini-Z all-wheel drive chassis, there is a hole here. I don't exactly know the reason behind it, but something like this would expose the gears to the road underneath, and in case of the debris can be caught in the gearing, and it might be very annoying or may cause further damage for the driving shaft. So for this reason, I put a tape over here to reduce such probabilities. That's all the issues I can point out at the moment for this particular Toyota Celica WRC. If there are more issues I can think of, I would gladly point them out.